Hello students, so now we'll be talking about the plant tissue, the simple, the permanent kind of plant tissue and its different divisions. So we already have discussed that the permanent tissue is of two types broadly. Permanent tissue is of two types, simple and complex. So now we'll be talking about simple and complex in detail. Simple permanent tissue is divided into three kinds. Simple permanent tissue right, three kinds: parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma, right? Now what are these, what are their functions and why do we call them simple? We call them simple permanent tissue because these are the tissues which are made up of cells doing same function, right? All of them have same origin and same function, right? The same kind of cells, simple permanent tissue. But if we talk about complex permanent tissue, then broadly complex permanent tissue is group of cells having different function. So now each cell has its own role. So made up of different kind of cells having different kind of function. That is called complex permanent tissue. Right? So let's talk about parenchyma cells of the simple permanent tissue. So what I let me draw the diagram of parenchyma cells. So if we see the structure, it is something like this, right? These are the basement cells, or sorry, the cells in the base, and as you can see, there is a lot of intracellular space, right? So we can see that the kind of cells it's forming, right? Now the parenchyma cells, now let's start with the important features of the parenchyma cells. First feature is that it is made up of thin cell wall. Second point, lot of intercellular space. It is intercellular, not intracellular. Intercellular means within the cells. Intercellular means between the cells, right? Then these are living cells, made up of living cells. Then they are mostly, note down the points, they are mostly made up of oval or spherical shaped cells, right? Then it is found in mostly all the parts of plant body. They're not restricted to a particular area, right? Then makes up the now what is the function? Packing material, and majorly its role is in food storage, right? Majorly its role is in storing the food, right? Now there are different kinds of parenchyma cells. Now how do we divide them? Some of the parenchyma cells have chlorophyll. That means they have the ability to do the photosynthesis. And these parenchyma cells are known as chlorenchyma because of the presence of chlorophyll. Some of the, in aquatic plants, some of the parenchyma cells have air cavities. So, to give them buoyancy when they are in water. And these cells are known as Aerenchyma. Right? So, Chlorenchyma and Aerenchyma are two variants of parenchyma because of what other role they are doing. Chlorenchyma because of ability to do photosynthesis, they are Chlorenchyma. And Aerenchyma because of the presence of air cavity to give buoyancy to the plants in aquatic conditions. Right? Now let's come to the Collenchyma. Next is Collenchyma. So what is Collenchyma? Let's first draw the diagram of it. A more compact kind of structure something like this, right? Having cell wall, right? Proper cell wall and even thickening in the corners. So in the corners they do have something like that, thickening in the corners. Give them a little rigidity, unlike parenchyma, which are more flexible and elastic. So Collenchyma is actually there. What are the features of the Collenchyma? Basically, they have, first point, unevenly thickened walls. That means walls are thickened but not evenly thickened, right? And the thickening is because of cellulose plus peptic material. So rest of the portion has cellulose, but the portion where there is more thickening is having peptic material, which is giving it strength, right? Which is confined to the corners. And it is absent in the roots. Now, what is the? It is also a living tissue, right? And living simple permanent tissue. And what is the main function of it? Function is to provide strength, at the same time, flexibility. Flexibility to the plant or the growing part of the plant, so that they don't they are quite delicate, so they need to have a little strength and flexibility in them, right? So that is about Collenchyma. Now let's talk about Sclerenchyma. Now, what is Sclerenchyma? First, let's draw the diagram of it. So, they are more rigid and very compactly arranged. right? And these cells are known as stone cells or sclerites, right? And they are also, they have something like the structure which is known as fiber. Now what are their roles? We'll talk about them now. So the first point for you to understand about them is that they are dead tissue. Till now, whichever simple permanent tissue we took, they were living tissue. But sclerenchyma is a dead tissue, right? They have thick, evenly lignified cells. That means the cell wall has lignin over them to give them more and more strength. They give, the function of them is to basically provide strength to the plant, right? Now they are made up of two types of cells. As we can see, first is stone cell. Now stone cell is known as also sclerite, right? Now stone cells are commonly found in shell of fruit or even pulp, some pulp of some of the fruit like pear. And the second one is fiber. Now these fiber cells or fibers are elongated strands, as you can see, and they are with simple pits, having simple pits and same function to provide strength, right? Mechanical strength. This is about sclerenchyma, made up of two kinds of cells, stone cells and fibers, right? Now let's talk about the complex permanent tissue. Note down this, all these points. If you want to know more about any of these, then let me know in the comment section. Let's talk about complex permanent tissue. So we have just discussed the simple permanent tissue. Now complex permanent tissue is combination of different kind of simple permanent tissue and much more. Complex permanent tissue. Now complex permanent tissue is of two types. I'll write here xylem and phloem. Now we will be discussing xylem and phloem in complex permanent tissue. So first we'll talk about xylem, right? Now what is xylem? Xylem is mainly involved in conduction of minerals, nutrients and water, right? And it forms a continuous tube by the fusion of elongated cells. Now it is made up of four elements. First one is tracheid, right? Now what are tracheids? These are elongated tapering cells. Tapering cells forming a tube-like structure, and they are mainly involved in the conduction of water and mineral. So then is vessels. What are vessels? Xylem vessels are again the they have tubes having perforation means pores in them, and like to form a pipeline structure. So they have pores and then this something like this, right, for the conduction of minerals and water. Then there is xylem fibers. Of course they are known as also wood fibers, right? And they give additional mechanical strength, right? And then there is xylem parenchyma. So I'm writing X here so that you understand. So xylem parenchyma is there. Of course, it has role in storing the food, but also it helps in the conduction of water. And it is the very important point. This is the only living tissue among all the elements. It's the only living tissue among all the elements in the xylem, which is complex permanent tissue. Right? Now let's talk about phloem. Phloem is mainly meant for the conduction of food to various parts of the plant. Now here I want to say that this is only unidirectional movement from root to shoot, but this is from leaf to root also and shoot also, right? So this is meant to in the conduction of food. It is also having four kinds. One is sieve element. Now what is sieve element? It is made up of two kind of thing: sieve cells and sieve tube. Now sieve cells are found in the lower plants of the plant kingdom, and sieve tube is found in the angiosperms. It is meant for the elements which are meant for the conduction of food. And then there is companion cells, as the name suggests, is helping out the sieve tubes and sieve elements in the conduction of helping elements for the sieve tube to conduct the nutrients. They have prominent nucleus and a lot of cytoplasm to provide raw material. Then there is phloem fiber, again to provide mechanical strength, and these are also known as bast fiber. And then there is phloem parenchyma, which is storage of food, is the main function, right? And stores food in the form of starch and fats. Now here the point to be noted is only dead tissue found in all elements. So in the previous one, in xylem one, the only living tissue was xylem parenchyma. In the phloem one, among all the elements, the only element which is dead is phloem fiber, right? Now in the next video, this is all about plant tissue. If you want to know more about any of the topic, then let me know in the comment section. Next we'll take the animal tissue part. Thank you.